An hour north of Boston sits Rockport, Massachusetts, home to one of the oldest fishing villages and one of the oldest artist colonies in the U.S.
I love it. It's so quaint and gorgeous. I wish it was warmer, but, you know, you can't have everything.
Yet to most, Rockport does have everything. Beaches, art, fishing, scuba diving, shopping, history, and music.
The feeling here is that you've really made a trip someplace, and you can really surround yourself with the things here that really matter. The scenery, the art, and of course the music.
And the food. At Red Skiff's, seafood lovers can start the day with crab cakes benedict and homemade fish cakes for breakfast.
It's excellent. Okay. I get it all the time.
Then it's a short walk to Motif Number 1, a former fishing shack well known to artists and said to be the most often painted building in America. Around the bend, wander into Bearskin Neck, where the streets are lined with quaint shops, galleries, and restaurants.
So you're having two stuffed clams and a fish cake?
Yes, please.
Three, $5, please.
At Roy Moore's, pick out a lobster, watch it being prepared.
All right, guys, anything else?
And then enjoy it on the back porch or down by the water. Just down the road, artists paint on the streets as they have for more than 100 years, drawn to Rockport for its magical mix of light and scenery.
It's absolutely beautiful. Just there's so many different beaches and rocky shorelines. You're just never at a lack of inspiration.
Rockport native and photographer Mark Kanagas agrees. His 6-foot canvas panoramas that look like paintings capture much of the seaside community's beauty and rugged landscape.
People talk about the light. I think it's more the landscape. There's so many things, the whole coast. If you go all the way around Rockport, the beaches, the lighthouses, you got Halibut State Park. So, I mean, good light can happen anywhere, but you need great landscape, and we've got just the best landscape in the world.
To see that landscape firsthand, head to Halibut State Park, where you'll find a beautiful granite quarry, a World War II observation tower, and hiking paths down to the ocean. Other must-sees in Rockport, the historic twin lighthouses. The paper house, where inside you'll find a piano and a grandfather clock made of rolled-up newspapers and varnish. And stop by the Seawall Scripture House. Here you'll see how a Rockport family lived in the 1800s and learn about Hannah Jumper, who organized a hatchet raid to stop the sale of illegal alcohol.
The women got fed up with this, and 100 women and 2 men under the leadership of Hannah Jumper took their axes. All women had axes then because they chopped the wood. And they came downtown and they went into the stores and they hacked up all the kegs and threw them out into the street. The streets ran with liquor that day.
If all the sightseeing has left you hungry, head to the lobster pool where you can enjoy a variety of fresh local seafood on picnic tables by the ocean. Order your lobster boiled, on a roll, or lazy man style in a clamshell. This restaurant is dog friendly and has one of the best spots in Rockport to watch the sunset.
Oh, it's absolutely gorgeous. It's really nice.
So whether you're in search of beautiful beaches, original artwork, great food, or just some relaxation, you can spend a day or forever finding it all in Rockport. For CNN, I'm Linda Ciampa.